Finally, interstate travel restrictions are finally lifted, but only if you're fully vaccinated. To make flying safer in the new normal, Asia is launching something new, and we got a privilege to check it out before the launch. Let's go! This is Faces, AirAsia's new facial recognition feature that replaces your traditional boarding pass with your face. The low-cost carrier had previously introduced Faces in Johor Bahru a couple of years ago, and now they've introduced an improved version that's more convenient and is also more portable, making it easier to deploy at all touch points. To find out what's new, we spoke to Mr. Javed Malik, AirAsia Group's Chief Operating Officer.
Well, Faces is something that we've been working on for the last almost 3 years, and it's our program for biometric travel. What does that mean? Simply, you don't need to take your passport, your ID, or any papers out anymore, and simply you use your face to travel. We allow you to check in, book a ticket, board the flight, and even buy products in the future using your face, simply integrated on our AirAsia Super App.
But wait, hang on. AirAsia is promoting a facial recognition feature in a new normal. Are we even allowed to take off a mask?
So we'd encourage our guests to keep wearing the masks. If, of course, you need to take it off for breathing reasons, whether you're eating, the onboard service, we don't have a problem with that. But we need you to be courteous, and we need you to be aware of your fellow passengers as well as protecting yourself throughout and our crew. But ultimately, our people will be wearing the mask throughout the time they interact with you. And it's something that we believe is the right way to go, following the SOPs of each government.
Previously, the old Faces required travellers to register through a kiosk. Now with the new Faces, you can activate it on your smartphone. AirAsia Faces will be rolling out starting next Monday for selected flights, and it will be expanded to more airports around the region starting next year.
So we're going to go live on the 1st of November 2021 here in Malaysia. And initially it will be at KLIA 2 from Kuala Lumpur to certain destinations out of this region. Ultimately, over the rest of this year and into next year, 2022, we will be launching it to a number of Malaysian airports. And each time we increase those airports, as well as other airports in our network through Thailand, Indonesia and Philippines, by the end of 2022, we will have the majority of our major hubs covered for passengers to use Faces.
Facial recognition can definitely make travel more convenient, but what about safety and privacy?
The partners that we've chosen to build this are the world leaders in border control biometrics. They are one of the only companies that have privacy by design built into the software itself. What does that mean? Every country that has its border control, the passport images are the most secure parts of our data. And this company, VisionBox, our partner, has complied to those international standards. So in our case, the data is compliant to every data standard in Europe, America, Australia, and Asia. And we're very confident that there is no data risks. First of all, we're not keeping the data unless the customer wants us to keep the data. And when we use the data, each day we are going through refreshing that data.
From a quick demo, Faces takes a few seconds to scan your face with its cameras and sensors. It is nowhere as quick as your smartphone's face unlock, but it's faster than traditional manual checks at the boarding gates. If more passengers are using Faces, this could potentially speed up the boarding process. At the moment, Faces is planned to be implemented at the boarding gates. This makes it easier to board your next flight, as you no longer need to fumble with taking out your boarding pass and ID for verification. In the future, Faces will be implemented at more touch points at the airport, including security checks before entering the departure area. At the moment, you need to scan your boarding pass when using the self-baggage drop. But in the future, all you need is to show your face to drop your luggage. If you're flying on AirAsia soon, here's how to get started with Faces. Firstly, download the AirAsia Super App. Register or log in with your details. Tap on Account and then go to Faces. Tap on Get Started. Then you need to take a selfie and snap a picture of your passport or IC. If the captured details are correct, you can tap Continue to generate a QR code. Before you can start using Faces, you must perform a one-time verification. Just show your QR code and your passport or IC at the service desk. Once you're verified, you can start using Faces. Faces work for children aged 12 years old and above, And just in case if faces couldn't recognize you, you still can scan your digital boarding pass at the bottom of the scanner. It also works when you travel in a group. We also asked Mr. Javid, how is it like to fly in a new normal?
Look, I just took my first trip after almost 19 months. It was a really enjoyable, exciting experience. Yes, it was different. I had to upload my certificates. I had to upload my vaccine details, but it was so enjoyable. I can't urge you enough, where you can and when you are allowed, please get on the planes, get back to living life as normal. Only through treating this as normal, everyday world can we get back to living our lives. But do it sensibly, be careful, take protections in terms of masks, sanitization, and you can get back to enjoying what we all do, which is enjoying each other's companies.
Overall, faces is an interesting feature to make air travel as contactless as possible. However, you need to take your face mask off briefly, which can be a safety concern. Hopefully, this can be mitigated with good ventilation at the airports and if all travelers practice physical distancing. Before making the next trip, it's recommended that you run a COVID-19 self-test and pack enough sanitizer and face mask with you. We're still not out of the woods yet, so take all necessary precautions and travel safe. That's all for now, and this is just a quick look at the new AirAsia Faces. So what do you think about Faces? Let us know in the comments down below. If you like this video, please give us a thumbs up, like us on Facebook, and don't forget to subscribe us on the YouTube channel and hit the notification bell icon so they'll be informed of our future videos. This is Alex from soyachincha.com. Thank you so much for watching, and we'll see you in the next one. Bye!